saying Jim and Doug each other, what does that got to do with you all? That's got a lot to do with me, what if they're saying one of the chief of my family in the school? I don't know if the chief of my children, that two men are supposed to be together, two women are supposed to be together. So it affects us by the moves they make, by the lifestyles they allow to operate on this planet. The fact that they might be teaching my children in schools is important. And so that ideal life is coming, into where a lot of people don't have the truth. We've got the truth. What if there are people who don't have the truth? And I'm saying, they'll never have a chance with the way the world is going to be. You find in the third most of them, they're fighting against God. They're taking the name of God, took the name of God out of school. Now, they don't even want you to say it, man. They don't want you to say Jesus anymore. And there are people who don't have the truth and never will have it if they don't have the opportunity as we have to. So the kingdom suffered violence and the violence taken by force. Which means you have to press into the kingdom because there's opposition. Now all spiritual warfare is fought in the minds of men. That's the powerful statement. We'll say that again. All spiritual warfare is fought in the minds of men. The object of demon spirits is to get into the minds of people. That's the object of the demon spirits, is to get into the minds of people. The devil is after your mind. Why? You see, if he can control your mind, then he can get you to do his will. Here's something else we need to see. God gave the earth to man. Satan knows the earth belongs to man. So either the kingdom of God and the kingdom of Satan will rule in the earth. But it's all come through men. And up to this point, shoulders, and you don't take authority over your mind, sooner or later, you're going to do his will. Sooner or later. And that's direct warfare. Indirect warfare, when he sends his mind to the mouths of other people. You know, Satan uses other people, he uses us to discourage people. Indirect warfare is when he sends his mind to the mouths of other people, which means he gets people to plan this out. Ephesians 6, 10 is where I'm sorry. Ephesians 6, 10 and 12. It says, finally, my brother, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. And of course, when you're asking now, you can say, who will? The follower here is talking to Satan. And he said, what he's doing, he says, finally, my brother, put on the have to have a source to keep us moving. We can't just get on our own. So either we're filled into God or we're filled into Satan. And so if you know what happens when you're filled into Satan, Satan gives us all these bad thoughts, all these bad ideas, and teaches us to do the wrong thing. But when Adam died, when Adam lost his way of heaven, and God gave him, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.